Kemmer gave me a lot of good advice. And one of the things that I asked him was, what should I do next after being in Cambridge? And he said, go to America. And he had come back from Chalk River, and he knew pretty well what was going on in America. So that was the initial impetus. And the next thing he said was, you should go and talk to Peierls. He knows even more about what is going on. And so at that time I had a motor bicycle, and I remember very vividly going on the motor bicycle from Cambridge to Birmingham and finding Peierls, spending an afternoon talking to Peierls. That was my first meeting with Peierls, and asked him what I ought to do. And he said specifically go to Cornell. And that was because, of course, he had been very close to Hans Bethe at Los Alamos. He knew that Bethe had gone to Cornell. And so he said you should try that. And that's where you could really get the kind of guidance that you need. And in addition, I talked to Sir Hugh Taylor, I mean, not Sir Hugh, Geoffrey Taylor, who was a hydrodynamicist at Cambridge, an experimenter. And I asked him the same question, and he gave the same answer. He said, also Cornell is the place. He had been at Los Alamos too. And so I had this very excellent advice, which otherwise I would never have known where to go. I mean, I'd never heard of Cornell, I think, apart from just being told about it by these two people. It wasn't in England, it wasn't so well known. Everybody had heard of Harvard and Yale, but nobody heard of Cornell. And Cornell, of course, was exactly the right place. So I then got, I don't know exactly how it happened, I asked how I could actually make the arrangements to go to Cornell, and they said the thing to do is to get a Commonwealth Fellowship. Probably Peierls suggested that, and so I applied for a Commonwealth, which in those days was a standard way for graduate students to come to America from Europe, and I got an interview in London, and they gave me the fellowship.